Are you willing to fight? Are you willing to grab? Are you willing to be the warrior? Bring your shield, bring your sword. Stand up and fight. Today will be the day where you can take control. Take control of your power. Become this power, because now is the time to fight.
You're a warrior. Warriors don't give up and they don't back down. Become the warrior. Transform your life. Transform yourself. Head out into battle. Step onto the battlefield. Use your weapons to fight through this pain. Fight through the rejection. Learn from the bruises, the blood, scars, because this time you can rise to become the victor. Step onto the playing field, because now is the time to change. Now is the time to rise with the crown on your head.
You know, you want to be a little bit better in some way tomorrow than you are today. But it's not going to be in a linear path. Again, these go through cycles of stress and recovery. So it's just kind of being able to surf the flow of that and know, again, it's really comes down to balance. So it's the practices. Like, you need to know what to do, for sure. And then you need to know how to apply those things in the right way. So when to push and when to take the pressure off the gas as well. And I think that's really understanding that. So part of it is the knowledge, and then part of it is the follow through, and then part of it is the discipline to know not only when you need to go, but when you need to rest. I think it's important to really trust that what you're doing is going to work. What's a day that makes life awesome and makes you, again, a little bit better tomorrow from having done it today? You have to really do the work. Like, you have to back it with hard work. You know, and if you ask Conor McGregor, like, what's the secret to his success? Hard work, hard work, hard work. I don't know if he actually works harder than anybody, but he believes he does. You know, he has no doubts in his mind that he's actually working harder. And that's, I think, important. So really making sure that you really do your best to get the goods, you know, and to practice that, and to go out there and put yourself out there. And then on the other side, what is the thing, what is the antagonist of belief? Well, the antagonist of belief is fear. You know, fear is a belief that something negative is going to happen rather than something positive is going to happen. So it's like, that's on the other side. You're almost believing in your failure, right? Rather than believing in your success. So you have to go attack and collapse these different fears. And part of that is gonna be sucking out the penalty if you fail, right? Because, like, a lot of the fear comes because we're afraid that we're going to judge ourselves harshly or whatever. So you got to realize, like, there is no such thing as failure. There's just learning, right? So you collapse the penalty for failure. So that collapses the fear, which allows you to believe even more. So that's one way to do it. And the other way is to just look at fear itself and play out the different scenarios. Know that you're going to be fine. Again, forgive yourself always. And really also just attack fear wherever you see it, even when it's trivial, even when it's some kind of, before we got on here, we talked about the fear of the number 13, trigatricophobia. Like, if you're afraid of 13, you know what you need to do? You need to put 13s all over your fucking house. You know, you need to, like, sit in 13s, you need to go to the 13th, demand to be on the 13th floor of every hotel and every airplane, because you got to get over that shit, because that is telling yourself that there's something irrational that should control you. And if you believe there's something that's irrational that should control you, that will apply universally. So wherever you find fear specifically that's out of balance with actual danger, like, I'm not saying touch a hot stove or put your hand in a rattlesnake cage, like, there's danger there, that's not fear. But 13, no danger, you know, that's not real. So go collapse that, the fear of crickets like I have, or fear of, like, whatever it is, collapse fear wherever you see it, and that specific collapse will help with the universal collapse of fear in general. You just gotta understand, the only thing that you're responsible for is your best. Like, you can't do better than your best. You just do your best. And if you try to obsess too much, you're not doing your best, you're gonna be paralyzed, right? So you have to get as much information as you can, make the most educated choice, make sure that you're not choosing based on ego or emotion or, you know, greed or these other forces that delude you and prevent you from thinking clearly. But if you do your best and you fail, like, what are you gonna do? Beat yourself up for that? Like, that doesn't make any sense. If you're doing your best, if you're really laying it out there, there's nothing more you can do. And that's, I think, that's really the key, is just to constantly rest and rely on that fact that I'm doing my best, and there's nothing more than that. You know, you have to really appreciate where you are in the journey and say, yeah, where you are is awesome, but you could be better, because that's the process is becoming better, right? So it's not judging it externally by any other criteria, because every step is good, but the process of striving for more, the process to really unveiling who you are to an even greater degree, to getting cleaner and clearer and more full and more robust and the best version of yourself, like that process is a beautiful process. I think it's one of the reasons why we're here. It feels the best. It feels the best to be continuing on the path. But that doesn't mean that you look forward to a point in the path, say, when I get there, I'll love myself. When I get there, I'll have made it. Like, love yourself where you are, wherever you are. That's awesome. But still strive for more, because the striving is the journey. It's always the striving. If we were able to do like even a fraction of the things we know we should, we would all be badasses, you know? But there's so many things. You talk to people, yeah, I should be doing that. Yeah, I should be doing, I know I should be doing, I should be meditating. Yeah, I know I should be doing this. I should be eating better. I should be doing this. Like, we all know what we want to do to be the best version of ourselves, but for whatever reason, we don't do it, you know? And there's a lot of reasons why, but we're not doing it. And so the ability to choose and actually decide what you're gonna do, to be the Nagual, to be the artist, and say, oh, well, if I believe I should meditate, then I'll meditate. And just collapsing that I know I should with actually doing it, you know, that is a superpower. That's what defines the greatest performers from the people who haven't quite made it yet. It's really their ability to say, oh, if I should train now, I will. Oh, if I should eat like this, I will. Oh, if I should do this, okay, then I will. It's collapsing that, knowing what you should do, and actually doing it, and making that one. And that's ultimately a choice. We have way more power than we recognize, and what people will tell us that we have. So stepping into that power and deciding for ourselves what we want to do with it.
What time is it right now? Look at it, face it, stand up to it. What do you see? What did that number say to you? How much of this number have you wasted on waiting? Waiting for what? What is it that you're waiting for? How much do you want it? Ask yourself this, what's more valuable, waiting or your time, your power, and your action? This is where your journey starts. This is where you grow, adapt, improve to become the person you admire. This is you. This can be you. Stop failing to respond, to react. This is how you shape your life, how you construct your future. Make this what it is, your success. All this work now are the steps before you break the ribbon at the finish line. This is your opportunity to change. Change towards a better life, towards a life where you are the director, where you are the power that drives you forward to success, the power that defines your life now, that defines your legacy, your future. This is the time to become something more than ordinary, something outside the realm of expected, because you're more than it. You always have been. But in order for you to become this, you need to work. You need to want it so much it pushes you outside your comfort zone. This is where it starts. This is where you become something better than now, where you build a life for yourself, one where you hold the reins, where you make the final cut, where you have that power. You deserve this. You deserve to feel fulfilled. Proud and excited for this newfound success you will and can embody. Your future, your legacy, your life can transform into the paradise you've always imagined it could be. Your life can change. Your life can be more than just a place. It can be your future, your success. This change takes courage. It takes courage to stand up and break down the aspects of your life that you know is holding you back. Let your progress be idolized. Let it speak for itself. Let it leave a mark so deep it can never be erased. This dent can have such a positive influence on your life that it can transform your future, transform your life using the potential you know you've always had. Make your life worth remembering. Make it worth the pain it took, the hours it used, the effort put in. Know to take pride in your work. Know that your life can break all possibilities, break all boundaries, and become something beyond